What's going on, everybody? I'm Joe Cho from SB Nation's bloggingtheboys.com here for you right outside AT&T Stadium as the Dallas Cowboys just defeated the New Orleans Saints 13-10. It was a win for the ages. It was one of the biggest games, one of the biggest wins of the Jason Garrett era, and DeMarcus Lawrence, Leighton Vander Esch, Jalen Smith, and the rest of the Hot Boys were on fire. This was a night. This was a game. This was a moment where the Dallas Cowboys completely shocked the world. It was a night full of history. Before the game, the 1993 Dallas Cowboys were celebrated for winning Super Bowl 28 25 years ago, and our own Tony Casillas, co-host of the 750 with me, had a little something to say with some of his former teammates.
All right, Tony Casillas with the Super Bowl 1993, Super Bowl 28. With Lee Bill Bates, Russell Maryland, and this cat over here.
J-Dub.
Also known as Drive-By.
And you got Vanderbilt behind you.
All right, so 25 years. What's the biggest moment, the thing you remember about this team? Bill, you go first.
What? It or makes me be first.
Go collectively.
I just love the teammates. It's how much fun we had together and how powerful we were together all the time.
All right, Big Russ.
I remember my man J-Dub showing out in that Super Bowl. got us that second ring. Yep, that's what I remember.
He's still upset he didn't get MVP.
Never upset, but I remember us being at the Gentlemen's Club having great dinners.
No, I wasn't there.
That's about it for right now.
After the 1993 Super Bowl champions were celebrated at midfield, the Cowboys kicked off, the game got going, and it was a slugfest all the way till the end. DeMarcus Lawrence, as mentioned, was a man on fire who backed up everything that he said all week long about taking it to the Saints. The Cowboys rookie wonder, Leighton Vander Esch, who was drafted inside of AT&T Stadium, was the heart and soul of their effort, along with his cohort, Jalen Smith, who talked after the game about his love and his affinity for Dallas Cowboys history. And again, as mentioned, Gil Brandt was enshrined in the Cowboys Ring of Honor at halftime. This night, it had everything for the Cowboys. It had pageantry, it had pomp and circumstance, and most importantly, it had a victory. The Cowboys held the New Orleans Saints to 176 total offensive yards. They punched Sean Payton, Drew Brees, Michael Thomas, Alvin Kamara, Mark Ingram, and all the rest right in the mouth. The Cowboys sit at 7-5, firmly in first place in the NFC East. They look like a playoff team, they look like a legitimate force to be reckoned with in the NFC, and they look like one of the best defenses, if not the absolute top unit in the National Football League. It was quite the night at AT&T Stadium. It was a whole lot of fun. We'll have so much coverage for you all week long at bloggingtheboys.com on our podcast feed, which you can subscribe to on all Apple and Android devices, and right here on the official Blogging the Boys YouTube channel. Make sure to subscribe and make sure you have a fantastic week. The Dallas Cowboys, first place, 7-5. It feels so good.